welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Garrett Ainsworth, the CEO of District Metals. And Garrett, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm doing great, Steve. Thanks very much.
So you put out a news release today talking about some 3D modeling you did of your Tomtebo project in Sweden. So tell me a little bit about, was it the whole property or were you sort of zoning in on a certain area?
No, this was just focused on the historic Tomtebo mine area where there's some historical drill results that we've been, we've digitized, we've put into a 3D model, and now we've modeled the mineralized zones. Now, one of the key things that really came out of this exercise is that we're dealing with a partial database of assays. So we acquired the data from an archive, essentially a museum that for the historic Falun mine, which is located 25 kilometers to the northwest. And there's a lot of assay data there, but we've noticed that there's a lot missing. But in a deeper dive, we found drill logs that show very encouraging results, such as massive sulfides that are indicative of grades that you'll likely see copper, gold, silver, zinc, lead. So that has been part of the modeling process, bringing in the sulfide information.
Yeah. So we're showing. I got to show a photo right now, basically of a bunch of different zones. So what did that data tell you about these particular areas?
Yeah, so 33 mineralized zones is what we've modeled at the historic Tomtebo mine. What's really great about it is that a lot of the zones are stacked. So with one drill hole, we can pierce through multiple zones. And we've basically created four different areas to follow up on: Oscar's Groven zone, Steffenberg zone, Gord's Groven zone, and Gamla Groven's. So with the highest priority being Oscar's Groven's and Steffensburg, as we feel that there's enough data there that suggests that we might be able to step in towards a resource delineation drilling in those areas. So it's very exciting.
And it also showed that this mineralization was not very deep either, which is another positive, I would think.
Yes, that's correct. Actually, one of the first drill holes that we'll be targeting mineralization at a depth of 42 meters. So very, very shallow. And we'll learn so much by drilling from, the shallow, almost at surface down to the 200 meter level. That will help us to really see the high grade plunges, and will really firm up our drilling when we start to go deeper than the 200 meter level.
And so Garrett, this 3D modeling that you did combined with your historic data, that's obviously, as you mentioned, giving you some ideas for drilling. So what is the next steps now? Obviously you'd like to get drilling, but there are steps you have to do before you get to the point where the drill goes in the ground.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've already picked our drill targets and we have an idea of the meterage to accomplish that. So we're at the stage right now with the historic Tomtebo mine where we are ready to start the permitting process. We're gonna wait for the SkyTEM results to come in because that will generate more drill targets so that we do it all at once for the historic Tomtebo mine area. And then we'll also be getting drill targets for the greater portion of the Tomtebo project. But we'll be permitting that on a different permit application.
All right. Well, there we go. We'll look forward to hearing more about that stuff as it continues to roll along. Garrett, congratulations on the 3D modeling, and we'll talk again soon.
Hey, thanks very much, Steve. Yep, talk soon.
All right. There's Garrett Ainsworth, the CEO of District Metals.